Hello and welcome to my tarot corner. And I don't know how to put it in the into embed it into the to the video, but I will put in the link below the a link to in the box below the link to a spread that I did regarding who will be the next one to do a tell-all interview. And then it was about Harry and his book, because that was the question. But there were two candidates. It was Alan and the one who did also already interview him. How is he called? Well, that British guy with the bus. And the cards showed that it was definitely leaning towards Alan. And then now we get that Ellen did another tell-all interview with Meghan. Now, I'm not going to ask whether or not this interview is going to be full of lies, as we do know that it will. My question is whether or not Ellen will regret this interview, just like Oprah does regret her interview, and will it damage her reputation just as it did Oprah's? And I have to make something clear. Ellen's reputation is not so wasn't so great to begin with, and she had a lot of complaints of the people who said that she's a bully. So this is could be something that is that she can relate to with Meghan. But so she needs to something that will rehabilitate her name and not make her look ridiculous. And this is exactly what she doesn't need, Jay. And the question is whether or not she will do that. I mean, she will. She already did that, so we know that she did. But whether or not she will actually regret doing it. And I'm using my new 9 card spread, and I will look on things around it, and because it has a lot of advice, so a lot of advice options, and so we can see. Sorry about that, that's my husband. And so we can see a little bit more information regarding the getting more advice for Ellen. So first I'm going to clear the deck. This is a mermaid tarot, and then I'm going to finish it with another fun oracle deck called Mermaids and Dolphins. So we are in the sea today. Okay, and so I'm starting with will Ellen regret having an interview with Meghan Markle? Why did she agree to do this interview knowing that Meghan is a pathological liar? Does she relate to Meghan bullying claims? Will she regret doing this interview? Yeah, I keep getting amazed on how much stage this woman gets when it is proven once and once again that she lies. Okay, so now we get the part, the far past, and in the far past we have the Eight of Pentacles, and the Eight of Pentacles is a card of someone who is working hard, someone who is working hard for even not getting a lot of money, although Ellen is getting a lot of money for her work, but still this is a card of someone who cares more about the work than the money. This is a card of apprenticeship. So maybe in the far past, before she got even famous, she did work very hard in order to get her fame and get her clout and get her reward. Because when this card comes up, it says, if you persist with working hard, with diligence, you will get rewarded in the end. So it does look like Ellen used to be someone who works hard, and maybe even someone who cares about her staff. And she wasn't the same person that we see today. So this is the far past. So what do we have in the near past? And in the near past, we have the Queen of Pentacles. So this is a card of someone who is the shopkeeper, someone who has have to be stable in the face of changes. Now things changed around Ellen, and she needs to show stability. And this is also everything connected with property, with money, with business. So today, this is, or let's say the near past, she became a woman who is like the shopkeeper, and really concerns herself only with the business and the money, and this is the most important thing for her. This is someone who is very practical, and her wish to do this interview, it's out of practical considerations. Okay, now what do we get in the current situation? And in the current situation, we get the Eight of Wands. Now, the Eight of Wands is a card of communication and things that are going very, very fast. Could be electronic communication, could be also television and radio and media. But this is something that is going on very, very fast, and this is a velocity and trying to do the right thing, trying to act the right thing, trying to be in the right place in the right time. And she thinks that the Sussexes are right now a hot name in the industry, so this is like getting her herself fast back into the conversation. And she doesn't really care whether or not it is a good or bad conversation, but at least getting herself very fast into the conversation, because she is interviewing the Duchess of Sussex. And as I told you before, the titles do mean to the Americans as much as they don't want to admit that. Now, the next card is the known influence, and the known influence is the Ace of Cups. And the Ace of Cups is a card of being able to realize the flow of emotions in the material world. So this is energy of freedom, of abundance, and belief that you deserve this. And this is what she believes. She actually believes that she deserves everything. She deserves happiness, she deserves abundance, and she deserves more than she gets. And she believes that she has the ability to fulfill everything. And this is the known influence. Now let's see what the hidden influence is. And the hidden influence is the Ace of Wands. Okay, and the Ace of Wands, another ace. And the Ace of Wands is the ability to fulfill or to make your wishes come true in the real life, in the material world. This is someone who creates from nothing, very much like the magician, only a more earthy card, which is more which can manifest better than the magician. So this is someone who is also egocentric, someone who is very easily angry. And this is the hidden influence behind Ellen, because she is egocentric. She is, we know by the bullying claims that she is getting angry very, very fast. And it still doesn't tell us whether or not she will regret interviewing Meghan, but what it does tell us that she believes that this is a part of realizing her wishes in the material world. Okay, probable outcome. So will she or won't she be sorry? And we get the Page of Swords. So Meghan will lie, as she does usually. The Page of Swords is the reporter, which is very fitting for Ellen. But still, this is someone who is very easily lying, a slick tongue, knows how to convince people with his words. So Meghan will lie, and this is something that her lies will be very evident, and this is something that will be something that Ellen cannot control, and it will be very evident in the in that interview, and I believe that people will come out with the, you know, debunking her lies just one after the other. So now let's see what kind of advice the tarot gives Ellen. So the first one is the Ten of Pentacles. So Ten of Pentacles is like wishes come true. This is the having your little piece of heaven. If you want to have this abundance, if you want to have this truth, this richness, this happiness, you need to think about things, you need to know how to act rightly. So this tells her that there are ways to get this, and she can get it. Interviewing Meghan is probably not the right way, but let's see what the next advice card tells us. So the next advice is a warning card, another 10. So we get here two cards that are end of a process, and this is the 10 of Swords, and this is a warning. So in one advice card, the tarot tells her, this is what you can get, and this is the warning, this is what can happen to you. And it's Swords, and it's not by coincidence that we got the Ten of Swords, when the outcome is the Page of Swords, the Princess of Swords, and it's the Page of Swords. And it's not a coincidence. The swords, the words, the talking, that will get her down. That will get her to the rock bottom place. Now here, it even comes out in a very cold and eerie place, and there is no sunlight coming up. There is no dawn coming up. Or if there is, it is something very, very, very small here. This person cannot see the dawn coming, and this is a very, very, very big warning to Ellen to be careful, especially from Meghan's words. Now, the third advice card we get is the King of Swords. And the King of Swords is the king that is the pacifier. He is the one that needs everyone to be okay. He is trying to appease everyone. This is an advice for her. Be the pacifier. Try to make peace with everyone. Don't do anything that is controversial. Don't do things that are that will make people angry at you. This is a very good advice for her. Will she take it or not? It is a good question. And let's see what the underlying message is. And the underlying message is the Six of Swords, which is vacation. So this card will actually tell her, you need to maybe take some time off and think about what you're doing. You need to She was on vacation, so this is coming back from vacation. But when you come back, you need to really think over, because sixes are also cards of second chances. And now she's getting a second chance with her TV program, and she needs to be very, very careful not to blow it over. So this is the underlying message. Now let's see what the oracle has to say. I have this feeling that this is the intuitive part of me that tells me that she will find herself in the Ten of Swords. She will find herself in this rock bottom place, and she will feel very much regret for doing this interview, just as Oprah does, because Oprah wouldn't wipe this interview completely from her sight and be completely detach herself from the Harpos if she wasn't feeling remorse about doing that interview. So let's see what the oracle says. So the energy is around Ellen doing an interview with Meghan. Ellen doing an interview with Meghan. So what does the oracle say? And we get healing heart. You're a powerful healer. Keep up the great work. So she has this ability, or she has the ability to heal things here if she does things right. And the oracle actually tells her to use those powers. Now, it doesn't have to be that she is a healer per se, but the actual interview can be a healing process if she makes sure that what Megan says is the truth and the right things, and not worsen things that already have been done with the royal family, not say more lies. So I think that only the future will tell us what kind of interview will it be. And I hope you liked it. And if you did, please like, subscribe, write me an email, write me a comment, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.